In this video, we will explore the steps to build and host a website using Python Anywhere. First, visit the Python Anywhere website. If you are new, sign up for an account or simply log in if you already have one. Now you can see the Python Anywhere dashboard showing your CPU usage and your files and apps. To create a website, let's click on the web link near the top right. Now click on the Add a New Web App. If you have a free account, your app will live at a Python Anywhere domain. If you have a paid account, you can use your own domain and configure however you like. Let's just go with the default domain for now. Click on Next. Now you can select a Python web framework for your application. Feel free to choose whichever web framework you are familiar with. Let's select Flask in this example. Then we need to choose a Python version. This will help you configure the needed Python environment. Let's select the newest available Python version here. And then next, we need to confirm where do we like to put our code. The default path looks pretty good to me, so we'll just go with the default. Click on Next. Now we can see the configuration page for our website. Click on this link. And here is our new website. This is a very, very simple example for you to build upon. You can always add more code. Okay, now let's take a look at the code. Click on the Go To directory and click on the Flask app.py file. You can see the code is really, really simple here. We import Flask first, load the Flask framework, and define this function, which tells us what happens when we go to this location on your site. Now, let's try to make some changes to this file and see what happens. Let's change the location to /foo and change the return text to hello from Python Anywhere. Click the Save button and then Reload button. Now let's add /foo to our website URL. And now we can see the changed web page. Okay, so that covers the basic steps for hosting a website on Python Anywhere. You can see it's super easy. It's completely free to get started. Don't hesitate to modify the code and develop more complex applications. Hope you find this video helpful, and we'll see you next time. Bye!